Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Please like, share, subscribe my channel. Now I am taking up problems, numericals on balancing of number of masses revolving in the same plane. I have selected a few problems. The first one is problem number one. Four masses M1, M2, M3 and M4 are, they have given this, M1 is 200 kg, right, 200 kg, M2 is 300 kg, M3 is 240 kg and M4 is 260 kg respectively, or attached to a rotating shaft, the corresponding radii of rotation are, first one is 0.2 meter, second one is 0.15 meter, R2 is 0.15 meter, third one is 0.25 meter and fourth one is 0.3 meters. So the radii are given, masses are given, radii are given, and the angles between successive masses means, he has given this, M1 is given, R1 is given, M2 is given, R2 is given, M3 is given, R3 is given, M4 is given, R4 is given. Now the angle between successive masses means, between 1 and 2 the angle is 45 degree. The angle between 2 and 3 is 75 degree, and the angle between 3 and 4 is 135 degree. This, now it is given like this, it means it is told like this, successive masses, the angles between successive masses are 45 degree, 75 degree and 135 degrees. Calculate the position and magnitude of the balance mass required if its radius of rotation is 0.2 meters by analytical method. Here it has been very clearly said by analytical methods. In some problem they have clearly said by graphical method. If it is asked, if it is told by analytical method, you have to do it by analytical method. If it is said by graphical method, you have to do by graphical method only. If nothing is said, then you can do it by any one of the methods. So here it is by analytical method only. So I will take this as the reference mass, so that will be 0. Theta 1 will be 0. Theta 2 will be 45 degree. Theta 3 will be 45 from here. From here it is 45 plus 75, that is 120 degrees. Theta 4 is 120 plus 135, that is 255 degrees. So these are the thing. Now we have to find out M5. R5 is given as 0.2 meters. We have to find out theta 5, the fifth mass, which is the balancing mass. Its magnitude and position, angular position, are to be found out by analytical method. I hope you have understood this very clearly. I have taken all the angles from M1, the reference mass. This is 45, this is 45 plus 75. From here to here it is 45 plus 75 plus 135. Now analytical method means, I have told you that sigma h, first you have to find out sigma h. M1 R1 into cos theta 1, that is 200, you have to write the formula, 200 into 0.2 into cos 0 plus 300 into 0.15 into cos 45 degree plus 240 into 0.25. I have not written the formula, but you have to write the formula. Cos 120 degree plus M4, that is 260 into R4, 0.3 into cos 255 degree. So this will give me sigma H. Take the calculator on 200 into 0.2 into cos 0 plus 300 into 0.15 into cos 45 plus 240 into 0.25 into cos 120 plus 260 into 0.3 into cos 255 cos 255 in one line. You go, it is plus 21.63. the answer is 21.63. unit is, these are all in kg, these are all in meters, so the products will be kg meters, so this will be kg meters, 21.63 kg meters. Similarly, sigma V is 200 into 0.2 into sin 0 plus 300 into 0.15 into sin 45 plus 240 into 0.25 into sin 120 plus 260 into 0.3 into sine of 255 degrees. Write it. First write the formula, then substitute, then calculate. 200 into 0.2 into sine 0, sine 0, plus 300 into 0.15 into sin 45 plus 240 into 0.25 into sin 120 plus 260 into 0.3 into sin 255 equals 8.44. again positive, 8.44 kg meters. This is sigma V, this is sigma H. Now M5 will be equal to square root of sigma H square plus sigma V whole square divided by R5. So that will be root of 21.63 square plus 8.44 square under root, whole thing divided by R5 is 0.2. So this will give you M5. So 21.63 square plus 8.44 square equals under root. So root of answer equals this much divided by 0.2 equals 116 kgs, because all masses are given in kgs. This mass also will be in kgs, the fifth mass. This is the balance magnitude of the balancing mass. Then theta phi is equal to tan inverse of sigma v by sigma h plus 180 degree from m1. So tan inverse of sigma v. Sigma v is 8.44 divided by 21.63 plus 180 degree. That is 8.44 divided by 21.63 equals, first divide this by this, then shift tan answer equals 21.3 plus 180, that will give me 201.3 degrees, 201.3 degrees from M1. So it should be placed 201.3 degree from M1 in the system, then they get balanced. The system gets balanced. That is, the total force acting on the shaft will become zero. That's it. Now we'll take up one more problem. Four masses. Next problem, problem number 3 from the question bank. Four masses A, B, C and D are attached to the shaft and revolve in the same plane. The masses are A is 12 kg, B is 10 kg, C is 18 kg and D is 15 kg. These are the magnitudes of the masses respectively, and their radii of rotation are Ra is the radii of rotation are 40 mm. This is, second one is 50 mm, third one is 60 mm and fourth one is 30 mm. So I'll call that as RB, RC, RD, radius of mass A, mass B, mass D. Like that, then you can mark it like this. They can be, all must be in the same unit. It doesn't matter what unit it is. It may be in meters, this thing, it may be. The angular position of the masses B, C and D are 60 degree, 135 degree and 270 degree from the mass A. So first mass is mass A, second mass is B, third mass is C and fourth mass is D. So from A, B is at 60 degree. From A, C is at 135 degree. And from A, D is at 270 degrees. So that means theta A is 0, theta B is 60, theta C is 135 and theta D is 270 degrees. Here there is no necessity to add them because all angles are given from A only, from the first mass, which is this thing. Mass A. Calculate the magnitude and position of the balancing mass at a radius of 100 mm. I will call this as E. I have to find out mass E. The radius is 100 mm and this theta E also I have to find out. Now he hasn't said whether it should be done graphically or it should be done analytically. If it is given like this, the option will be on your side. You can do it either graphically or analytically, whichever you feel is better one, you can do it. Anyway, you have to find out mass E and theta E. Now, I will do it by analytical method. Now, here, again, I have to find out sigma H and sigma V. So, 12 into, this can be 40 only, cos 0 degree, plus 10 into 50 into cos 60 degree, plus 18 into 60 into cos 135 degree, plus 15 into 30 into cos 270 degree, whatever is given. So there are four masses, usually they give four, and fifth mass they will ask us to find out. So 12 into 40 into cos 0 plus 10 into 50 into cos 60 plus 18 into 60 into cos 135 plus 15 into 30 into cos 270, that gives me minus 33.67 minus 33.67 unit is, these are all in kg, so kg, these are all in millimeter, so kg millimeter. Now sigma V will be 12 into 40 into sine 0. You have to write the formula, I am not writing it. 10 into 50 into sine 60 degrees plus 18 into 60. 18 into 60 multiplied by sine of 135 degree plus 15 into 30. Into sine of 270 degrees. 12 into 40 into sine 0 plus 10 into 50 into sine 60 plus 18 into 60, 18 into 60 into sine 135 plus 15 into 30 into sine 270 equals. I think I am getting it wrong. 12 into 40 into sine 0 plus 10 into 50 into sine 60, sine 60 plus 18 into 60, 18 into 60 into sine 135 plus 15 into 30 into sine 270. I am getting the same thing. 746, it is positive. 746.7 kg millimeters. Now I want E, mass E will be equal to root of sigma H square plus sigma V square divided by RE. So that will be root of minus 33.67 the whole square plus 746 0.7 the whole square divided by Re is 100 mm. So that will be 100 only. Now this negative will become positive because you are squaring it. 33.67 square plus 746.7 square equals square root of that whole thing, root of answer 747 divided by 100, that will be 7.5 kg. Roughly, it is 7.5 kg. And theta E will be equal to again tan inverse of sigma V by sigma H plus 180 degree from mass A. From mass A. So that will be tan inverse of sigma V 746.6 divided by minus 33.67 plus 180 degrees. This will give me how much? 746.7 divided by minus 33.67 equals so much. I got that shift tan answer equals minus 87 plus 180, that will give me 92.6 degree from mass A. That means it will come somewhere here. Somewhere here you will have to attach that mass A at this radius to balance it. So that finishes that problem. Now this can be done either graphically or analytically, I told you. Next, I have selected question number 5 from the question bank. The question goes like this. 5 masses A, B, C, D and E are attached to a shaft and revolve in the same plane. Mass A is 250 newton, B is 160 newton, C is 210 newton, respectively. He has given 3 masses out of 5 and their radii of rotation are equal, that is RA, RB, RC, RR equal. We will call them everything as R. Now you have to find out the masses D and E. Find, calculate the magnitude of mass D and E for complete balance. He has given the angular position of masses B, C, D and E are 60 degree. So this is 0. Theta A is 0. Theta B is 60 degree. Theta C is 135 degree. Theta D is 210 degree. And theta E is 270 degree from A, all masses from A. Solve by analytical method. So he says solve it by analytical method. Here we are not going to attach a fifth mass. We have mass A, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, this is E, all attached to a single shaft and their radii, all radii are equal. This is also R, this is also R, this is. We are not going to attach a sixth mass. They should balance themselves. That means the resultant must be equal to 0 here. resultant of all forces must be equal to zero. Now you have to write, if the system is to balance, by itself without adding one more mass, then sigma h should be equal to zero and sigma v also must be equal to zero. Both must be equal to zero, sigma h and sigma v. So sigma h is equal to zero means, h is equal to zero means mass A into R into cos theta A plus mass B into R cos theta B plus MC R cos theta C. I have written this R, R, R because they are all equal, plus MD R cos theta D plus ME R cos theta E must be equal to 0. That means 250, I'll take out R as common factor, 250 into cos 0 plus 160 into cos 60 plus 210 into cos 135 degree plus MC, MC is what? D. D I have written twice. Sorry, C I have written twice. No, correct. MC, it is correct. 210 to 135. MD, I don't know. Into R I have taken out. Cos theta D, cos 210 degree plus ME, I don't know. R I have taken outside, into cos 270 degree. This must be equal to 0. Now take your calculator. Calculate it. 250 into cos 0 will be 250 only. 250, this will be 250 plus 160 into cos 60, cos 60 degree, that will be 80 plus 210 into cos 135, this will be minus 148.5 approximately, plus MD into cos 210, cos 210, this will be minus 0.866 plus ME into cos 270 is minus 1. Cos 270 is 0, so this is 0, is equal to 0. 0 divided by R, this R I have transferred that side, 0 divided by R, that also becomes 0. 250 plus 80 minus 148.5 gives me 181.5. If I add these three, I get 181.5 minus 0.866 MD is equal to 0, because this also becomes 0. So 181.5 will be equal to 0.866 MD, or MD is equal to 181.5 divided by 0.866. 181.5 divided by 0.866 equals 209.6 newton. This is the value of this. D will be 209.6. It should be so many newtons, because these are all newtons. Its radius is R, this radius is also R. So it is 209.6 newtons. Now, if we equate sigma V is equal to 0, we will get the value of ME. We will get the value of ME if we put sigma V is equal to 0. So if we take sigma V is equal to 0, sigma V is equal to 0, then what you get, R you can remove outside, 250 sin 0 plus 160 into sin 60 plus 210 sin 135 plus, now we know this, 209.6 into sin 210 degree plus ME, only unknown now, into sin 270 is equal to 0. This R again you are going to send that side, it is going to die. Now 250 into sin 0. Sin 0 is 0, so this will be 0. First one will be 0. Plus 160 into sin 60. Into sin 60 equals 138.6. 138.6 plus 210 into sin 135, that will give me 148.5 plus 209.6 into sin 210, this will be negative, minus 104.8 plus ME into sin 270 is minus 1. This is equal to 0. Now if I add this, 138.6 plus 148.5 minus 104.8 will give me 182.3. 182.3 minus ME is equal to 0. So 182.3 is equal to ME. I got this as 182.3 Newton. This is the answer. Now this he has said, do it analytically only. You can do it graphically also. You can do it in that force polygon. The last two lines closing lines will represent D and E. You will have to calculate them by using this scale.